Hey, hello, nice to meet you. In this video, we're gonna learn about how to protect your Arduino project from cloning. Every microcontroller has a protection feature. The ATmega328P is the heart of this Arduino board. It always has that feature. Today, we're gonna use that feature to lock the chip and prevent cloning. Coming up, here we go. First of all, we're gonna need two pieces of software, AVR Toots and Arduino IDE. And we need an AVR programmer. If you have an extra Arduino board, then you can make an Arduino ISP programmer by just uploading Arduino as ASP sketch. So open the Arduino IDE, go to Files, Examples, select the Arduino ASP sketch, then click on Upload. Now this Arduino board is an Arduino as ASP programmer. Now we're gonna need the hex file of our project. For instance, I'm gonna use this Blink sketch as my project, but you have to use the project that you wanna compile to hex file. Well, the Arduino IDE will store the compiled hex file temporarily in a temporary secret location. I'm gonna reveal it now. Go to your C drive, open the users folder, then you can see a folder having the username. Probably your name, it's my name, so open it. Then you can see a folder called app data. If it was not there, just go to view and check the hidden items. Here we go. Open the app data folder, then local and go to temp, open it. This is the secret location that I'm talking about. Well, then compile your program with the proper settings. I mean, are we going to compile the program for Arduino Uno ATmega328P MCU? So select the Arduino Uno on the board manager, then click on the compile button. Here you can see the two folders called Arduino build and cache created automatically. These are temporary folders. So do not close the Arduino IDE because it will automatically delete those folders. We actually need them. Well, open the build folder. Here you can see the compile hex file having the .x extension. There are two versions of it. One with the bootloader and without bootloader. I prefer without bootloader, so drag and drop the file into the desktop. Now we got the hex file of our project and we have the programmer. Now what? We're gonna program the ATmega328P with copy protection. So, wire up the Arduino as ASP programmer to the target ATmega328P chip like this. For brand new chips, the crystalline capacitors are not necessary. Or you can use the Arduino board directly like this. We're gonna use the Arduino directly because that's easy and no need for a breadboard. Connect the programmer Arduino to your PC, open up the AVR Toots, go to preset and select Arduino as ASP. That will automatically select the programmer as Arduino. Now we have to select the programmer connected port. Mine is on the COM4, so I'm gonna select that, but you have to select yours. Then click on the detect button. If you did everything right, it will detect your chip successfully. Yeah, to detect our chip at ATmega328P, see? Now we have to browse the compile hex file for project. Click on the flash browse tab over here, then browse the hex file, which is on my desktop over here. Select that and open it. On the bottom, check the erase flash and EEPROM checkbox. And this is the one last important step, the fuse bits and lock bits. Fuse bits are literally configuration bits. And these bits settings are made in microcontrollers to control certain operations that are not normally changed during the execution of a program. And the lock bits are made to enable or disable some special security features of a microcontroller. And this is a thing that we're gonna use to provide protection. The ATmega328P has three fuses, low, high, and extended, which define these functions. For ATmega328P, for a 60 MHz external clock, we can use these settings, and which is the by default of an Arduino Uno. So, clear all the fuse bit text box, and set the fuse bit values like that. So, I'm gonna set the H fuse to 0xFF, L fuse to 0xDE, E fuse to 0xFD. And about the lock bit. For lock bits, click on the bit selector. Don't be panic about this. I'm here with you. It looks complicated, but it's not complicated. You can always set the fuse bits through the bit selector, but I don't want you to be more complicated. From the datasheet of ATmega328P, we got this. This chip has 6 lock bits. Access to the internal flash from code, either from bootloader or application code, can be restricted using boot lock bits. And access to the flash program memory using an external programmer can be restricted using lock bits. So, if the boot lock bits and lock bits are programmed to 0, then it will completely disable access to the flash and EEPROM memory using an external programmer as well as using bootloader or application code. That's exactly what we need, right? Hence, we have to program the bits to 0 to make that happen. So, check on every checkbox to make that bits programmed to 0, click OK, and check the set fuses and set lock checkboxes, click the program button. That's it. We program the chip, we lock the chip. If you have any questions, If you have any doubts about it, or is it hard to believe, just try to read the chip, okay? Just uncheck every checkbox, change the right option to read, select the format to Intel Hex, browse the location that you want to save the file, enter a file name you like, click on save, then click on the go. Let's see what we got. Flash is empty, resulting file has no contents, and this is the original hex file. This is the hex file we got from the chip. See, we got nothing. But what is this? It's just a marker for EOF, end of file.